All right, everyone, welcome back for another episode of Carnivore Trade. Today is Wednesday, September 15th, 2021. So market's getting a nice rally today, up just shy of 1% right now on the SPY. S&P futures did come down and touch that 50 MA this morning, and they could not break it through that. And so path of least resistance was up. So you notice you had the kind of like this little kind of gamma wall here in this 442.7 to about 443.5 area. Couldn't break that through, and path of least resistance took you higher. Market being led higher today by energy. So crude having a nice day. Initially we had, so a nice little blast off there on crude, but initially we had an inside day here on XLE, and I tweeted that out, but it was able to get above yesterday's high. So right here, you're going to have the 100 moving average, and you're going to have that 51. Yeah, right about here, this 51 handle is going to be resistance on the XLE. XOP, kind of same deal here. Started off weak, but then had an outside day. This should have some resistance around 91, 92. And then you got the OIH there. Let's take a look at the OIH. Yep, so OIH, again, probably that 100 moving average, you have this sell-off bar here as well. Will be resistance. But again, to go back over crude, so we got to the 72 handle. I think that we will have some resistance at 74. I don't see it getting too much higher than that. Again, this is basically just trading higher off the yield. Market has been pegged to the yield for a while now, so it's really just doing that and reacting to the yield going up. As we see, tech is a little bit weaker, but still having a decent day. In the patrons, we took some profits today on Zendesk. So that was a trade we gave out on Monday. And this one blasting off to the upside. We're still holding this one for a much higher move. So nice job there for you guys. And yeah, really with volatility taking a hit, look at volatility intraday. They really blasted it in the last hour or so. And I tried warning you guys, like, this is, you know, it's OPEX week, it's a quad witch. They're not likely to break the market down during, you know, with this type of with an OPEX week. And I think Zero Hedge reported saying that this was one of the largest OPEX weeks ever. There was over $2 trillion in options expiring this week. It's not likely to, you're not likely to get a big move when that happens. There's going to be a lot of chop, a lot of theta burning. And that, we can see that's basically what's happened. We had, gap up yesterday, and the same thing Monday, gap up, sell off, gap up, sell off. And now we're rallying back, and we're finding some headwinds around this 448.50, 449 area, which is basically where we opened the previous 2 days. And then you had this chop from last week. So that's probably going to be a little bit of resistance. But yeah, bulls taking over today. And I don't think we get too much higher than 450, at least by the close this week, as that's where there is a lot of call and put volume really pegged to that 450 number on the SPY. So just be advised of that. But yeah, overall, a pretty big move up for the market. And yeah, just again, you know, we're not seeing any sort of confirmation signals. I talked a lot, you know, about the semis yesterday. Semis having a decent day today. Again, tech a little bit weaker, but you know, I talked about this yesterday. This isn't an uptrend. There's nothing wrong with the trend. It's above all four major moving averages. It's basically printing an all-time high, you know, or close to it every day. And without the semis showing weakness, you know, this market is, it's probably not likely to break down, even with the IWM struggling like it has for quite some time. I had a pretty big, you know, I had a pretty weak day yesterday, but I'm getting some, you know, a nice relief rally today. Transport's doing well. Today, at least coming off the lows, but this is still in a, you know, macro wise is still, you know, underperforming the market. So you know, again, there are signals there that this market breadth is weak, but in my opinion, we're not quite ready to fully break down yet. And again, the VIX, you know, if we take out this this low here on the VIX, it's probably going right back down to that 15.50 handle. So just be advised of that. And I think we have a good chance of getting down there. So just bear that in mind. But yeah, anyways, outside of that, really, energy, financials, typical sectors are leading right now with the higher yield, at least for today. Markets rallying a little bit into the close here, although pulling back just a little bit now as we have about a minute left in the day. But anyways, yeah, that's about all I got for you today. Stay tuned. If anything changes, I will let you know, of course. And if you want to come check me out on Patreon, it's patreon.com/carnivoretrades. We're throwing swing trades out there as much as I see them. And we've had a few winners lately. So yeah, if you want to get on that, it's $5 a month. I know you guys got Amazon Prime. Jeff Bezos doesn't need any more money, so might as well make some money, and then you can spend more money on Amazon. How about that? All right, anyways, guys. All right, take care. I'll talk to you tomorrow, and have a great rest of your night.